Today, we are going to format our user details response, because right now it's going to give us an create.email, email verified.id name and whatever. So the user details right now are pretty bad. And if you go to backend, right now we are just having a slash me here, but we are going to create a user controller obviously, and have another method. So let's make the controller php artisan make controller users controller, and instead of request user, let's let's make a route group for out API. So route group, which takes an array and a method, a closure. So let's put it here. I close that terminal. So we have, for example, here it takes a middleware, and it was API out. And we can remove the middleware just for this route, and it is a slash me, so it's going to take users controller at me, and let's give it a name of me, API me. Okay, so let's go to our user controller and let's create this new method, public function me, and let's return authenticated user. And obviously import use illumination support facades. Oh my god, what is with these notifications? Let's hit again refresh and see if it is still working. Target class API does not exist. And it is like that. Namespace controllers API. Okay, and we are getting an error. API controller not found. That's because we need to import, since we changed the namespace to controller slash API backslash API, we need to import the controller from app HTTP controllers controller. So right now it's getting an error because app HTTP controller user control does not exist. Let's go to api.php, and here we have to give it the API namespace like we did with the other controllers. Oh, and we need to move the controller. We forgot to move it. It was generated on the root HTTP controllers folder. So right now, let's refresh the page again. And obviously you have an error because it was out API, the class name. So let's refresh again. And we have our details returned like we did, like it was before, obviously. So what we need to do is to change this response. If we go to laravel.com and search the documentation for resource, we have our PHP artisan make resource and the command, and this is generating basically a new class that is going to create either a JSON resource or a collection resource. A collection resource is basically if you want to format every item in an array, in a collection, not in an array, you have to use a JSON a collection resource. But if you want a single item, it's just a simple resource. So let's do that. We basically need it for user. So PHP artisan make resource user. But if we want, for example, to format all the users, we need the collection resource. So PHP artisan make resource user. And on resources somewhere, HTTP resources, we have our user.php. If we go to the documentation and scrolling a bit down, obviously, toArray basically takes a new returns a new array. So we have to do something like that, and this will give us all of the resources for our user. And this is basically the current object. So this ID is basically the user object. This. So we need just the name, email, and create that. So name. It's this name. Name, yeah. Email. It's this email. And we have the created that. It's equal with this created that. But since this one, it's an array, we can change everything, the key. The keys. For example, instead of created at, maybe we want something like joined at or something like that. I'm going to leave it like that because it's what we have on our database, but you can easily change it. So going to users controller, if we go to the documentation again, this is basically you need a new instance of this and passing the object that you want to pass. If it was a collection, you had to pass a collection. Since we are is just a single resource, we have new user resource. Actually, new user, and it's from, we're going to import it. It's a new user, and import it from app HTTP resources user. I think we should refactor this to user resource or something like that. So let's do that. Let's refactor, rename user resource. Okay, and change the import, it changed the name here. Checking out right now again. Let's go and refresh the page. We are getting just what we wanted, but it's adding a new data level. So instead of having it directly here, we are using it with email and name. And let's do again a return. Let's comment this out and see the difference. So we have return authenticated user. Before Laravel resources, there was and it is actually still using it, some of it's used widely, the fractal package for transformers. So the format was actually pretty bad. So we can do, for example, on user resource, we can do format. Hopefully, I'm not sure if the method was like that, but we just need the date. Actually, because we can remove the data param there, but we are going to need it when we are listing some objects. So let's leave it like that for these two, so we won't have difference. But obviously, since we are doing that, my bad. For some reason, it removed the import. So we need to import that too. Okay, so right now, we have our name. Let's check the console log. We should go to our front end. And here on our store user actions on me. And here on our me, instead of response.data, we should do response.data.data. And let's remove the console log. So right now if we check the store again, we have the user details with payload that is correct. The user details has everything that we need. On our layout, so let's go to, actually we don't have any layouts, and that's pretty bad, because right now we are using our app.view that looks like a layout. It's router view. That is one layout, is our app layout, but we need to have for example another one for our authentication. So let's create a new folder on our views. Let's call it layouts, and let's create a new file that it is, for example, out layout. My bad, out layout.view. And let's do a template and the router view. Actually, let's leave it like that for the moment, but let's do a script. Export, default, nothing else, and the router view. To have the layout, we need to change actually a lot of code, because app is going to have only router view, and after that each layout should have its own. Let's go to our router index.js, and here we see component home and register, forgot password, reset password dashboard. Here we have to do something more. So for these two we need the layout, and for this forgot password, reset password and dashboard we need another one. So let's do something. Let's create, for example, app layout 2. My bad, I spelled wrong the out layout name. Let's copy everything from here. My bad. Okay, so let's rename this. Out layout. That's perfect. On app.view, we should return basically everything. So here we should have, for example, a vapp. This is for app layout. And app.view. That it is map getters. We still need to keep our me call, for example, because we are doing it on refresh. So, but on out, basically, let's copy everything from here to app layout and leave app.view without anything. Actually, we need to still keep the update notification. Let's see what we have to remove. So we have vapp. And we can remove the logout, the navbar. And we can leave the v content here. And the snack bar, because we still have on all layouts we have notifications. So app.view should keep the v snack bar and content. Obviously here we can remove this data, which is, it was empty. On computer we have logged in and all notifications. We can leave it like that. We have remove and add notification. Logout user. Logout user should be only on app. So logout user should be only on app layout. It's already, so we can remove that. And update notification. So we have to remove the logout map action too. So we have check user state. We're going to see what we keep on what not after we do the app layout. And here we have our snack bar. We don't really need the vapp. We don't need the snack bar either. We only have this V router. And we need V content. Actually, not V content. Let's go to app.view. So here we don't need this. Let's remove that and let's keep it like that. So we have V router, the snack bars, and on app layout, we have V content. And we are keeping the nav bar and obviously nested V content. Let's say app layout. We don't need the data right now. We don't need the notifications. We don't need the remove notification. So, and neither the update notification method. We have the logout user here. And we need to add the notification. So we have logout user. Okay. Do we need the check user state? The check user state is the set logged in state of the user. So let's go to user module. So on store user actions. And let's search for set user. My bad. Maybe I was wrong. It is a map action. It's user set logged in state. So it is here, and we are checking the token. If it is logged in, it's changing. So it's all right. But not here. We needed only one created app.view. So let's remove that too. And let's remove the created hook because we don't need it right now. Is the user logged in? It is. So that's all right. Let's go to app.view. And here we have logged in, but we don't really care about it anymore. And update notification, check user state. That's all right. It seems like it's all right. On our, this is not going to work. We basically have a broken application. What we need is to have the V application, and on app, let's go to main.js. Here it's mounting application and it's rendering the app component. So on app layout, actually on router.js, router index.js, we have to use the two layouts. So for example, let's say for out layout, we have the same thing. No, we just need this V content router view. So how we do that? Well, let's go to router index.js and let's copy some component. And let's say that path nothing. We have the component imported. Let's import it like we did with our home page. So we have our out layout. From views, it's layouts, and it is out layout. So instead of doing that, let's put it, instead of chunking, let's use the out layout component. We don't need about the meta for this one, but we have children, which are basically just routes. So let's move the login and register routes inside. Hopefully I'm not wrong because it's a lot of time since I did that last time, but let's see if it is working. So on our dashboard, and the path is required, and we don't have a name, it's just out. that I put that path slash. So slash login. Oh, we have our check. So let's clear our local storage. And let's try again. So we have our login page. And let's try and see if it is working. So let's check on our layout. Let's put some H1 and see if it is working. So we have our out layout, but if we go to dashboard, obviously we are not logged in, and we are going to do that. So Peter programming with peter.com and password. That one is using still the app.view layout, but we can go and say that on our router index.js, we have to do the same thing that we did with each route. Actually, the forgot password and reset password has the same layout as our route. So we have to move it here inside with the register ones. But dashboard and home doesn't matter. Home it should have its own layout. But dashboard should have the same thing. So let's copy dashboard actually. Let's go and import the app layout. My bad. It's app layout. App layout.view from layouts. Let's say that the path is slash and we have name app layout. Doesn't matter the name actually, we can forget it. And let's remove the meta and say that the component is app layout. And let's say that the children, so we have the children array. Children basically, like I said, it's an array of routes. So it will render whenever you have the nested router view. So right now we have dashboard as a nested for app layout. And as you can see, we have the head bar already, because on app layout, we already have the app bar. That is the navbar. So everything is still working, but we have out layout. So obviously that is not the layout that we want, it's ugly, but we are going to change it on the next episodes when we are going to go to styling, because this application I plan to finish it and it's going to take a lot of time, but hopefully next year we are going to end it. And right now we have layouts implemented for each route. For example, maybe we want something. Let's create the profile route. So let's go to views and we can have pages. Let's copy the dashboard one and let's call it profile. This is the profile page. We don't actually need, we are going to need a getter, but let's do it later. So let's console log this. Oh, actually, I was wrong. We need to fix this, because right now, if we don't check if we are logged in on created of application, it's going to give us errors. So let's go and create the profile. So profile.view. Let's go to router index and have the new route that we just created. Actually, we need to create the route. So slash profile. The name should be profile. Webpack chunk name is profile. And the component is profile.view. And we need to be logged in to access this. So right now, let's go and log in. So Peter programming with peter.com and password. Logging in. Let's go to slash profile. This is a profile page. That's actually perfect, but what we need is to display a card. So let's go and copy the card from our Woot login. And it is a V container. Let's copy everything. And we're going to remove what we don't need. The form, actually, that's what we don't need. So we don't need the div, we need the V container. Okay, so we have the row. And the title should be profile card. Details. And obviously we don't need the form. And we don't need the actions either. Not at least now. So here let's say that it is user details. Just for testing out. So we have our card. Here we need to take the user logged in credentials. So let's say that we have a map, a computed property. And we need map getters. And let's say user details is taking user slash user details. And obviously we need to import map getters from Vuex. So let's check that user details. And let's say that we have piece with strong user details dot name. I want to test it out. Right now, user details, it's empty because the page refreshed because of the hot reload, obviously, and we don't make the request on refresh. So on our app.view, actually, we don't, since we are making guest request on app layout, we can just no, let's do it on app.view. On our app.view, we have to make the request for get user details. So what we did on dashboard, we store this page user me. We just need to get app.view me. So let's do it like that. Let's map the action. Let's say me. It's user slash me. And on created, since check user state, I can't go there with the so let's go to user store module actions and set logged in state is returning a new promise. So check user state, we have to go do a then and check the getter is logged in. So if it's not, if it is logged in, we have to fetch the user details. So let's do is logged in user slash is logged in the getter. I think it was called like that, so we need to check it out. Logged in, not is logged in. So user is just logged in. So if this dot is logged in, actually, if this dot is logged in, we need to do the this dot me, which will make us the request. Unknown getter logged in. It's logged, not logging in. So it's logged in. My bad. This was one of my mistakes. And users details. Obviously, we need to instead of user slash user details, it's user. The module name is user. So on profile.view, the module name is user, not users. So we have the name. Let's refresh the page to get rid of the errors. So let's do, for example, name. And actually, the strong should be for the label. Okay, let's copy this and let's say email. And let's copy one more for created that. So, or joined user dot created at. So right now we have our details and everything is still working. We just have to log in. And it is still working. If we, for example, we go to profile, it's working, logging out. If we try to go to profile right now, it won't let us, it's redirecting us to log in. So this is actually perfect. I'm going to stop right now because we need to edit the profile and it's going to take more time, and I'm going to do that on the next episode. So let's commit our changes. And for frontend, we created a few files. We created the layout folder, and actually, so right now we have layout support, and we can make as many as we want and go as nested as we can or want, because we can like forever, if it makes sense, obviously. So let's say that we have add layout support. Add user details profile card. Add me check. Actually, add. No. Send request on page refresh for user details. Let's commit our changes. Hopefully I didn't forget anything. No. Let's go to the backend because we made changes here too. So what we did? Well, we created the user controller. So add users controller. Add user resource. We're going to change the responses with resources. So I think it's a good idea to give a check for the Laravel documentation on it, because it's actually pretty powerful and you can change the response. And for example, maybe if we if the authentication user facade will give us the password, it's mandatory to change the response. We can't just return our authentication user. Obviously Laravel removed that from the response, but if we didn't, you should. So let's commit the changes, and we created the a new route. Actually changed the route with and created a new group. Okay guys, thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this kind of videos, please subscribe, leave a like, maybe comment, and let's see each other on the next one.